Good day, everyone. My name is Mr. Chief Film Great, and today we'll be looking at the scapula. We'll be looking at the scapula bone. This is the scapula bone. You can see how the scapula bone is positioned. This is the scapula bone. So we'll be discussing the important features in the scapula bone and the different parts of the scapula bone. You can place your hand at your back here, and you feel this scapula bone. This is it. So, this part of the scapula bone, you can see how the scapula bone is positioned. So, looking at the position, this part of the scapula bone, seeing that it comes medially, it is closer to the midline. So, this part is referred to as the medial border of the scapula. This is the medial border of the scapula. While this part is the lateral border of the scapula. Then we have another important feature in the scapula. You can see this angle here. You can see this angle. This is referred to as the superior angle of the scapula because it is placed superiorly. While this is referred to as the inferior angle of the scapula. You can see the inferior angle of the scapula. It is more inferior when compared to the superior angle. And that's where the name superior and inferior came from. So this is the superior angle, while this is the inferior angle. So we've been able to see the medial border, the lateral border, the superior angle, and the inferior angle. Then let's look at the next feature in the scapula. We can see this fossa, right? This fossa, we have about three fossa in the scapula. We have this, and we have this. So this is referred to as the
supraspinous fossa,
while the one below is referred to as the
infraspinous fossa.
And this one here is referred to as the subscapular fossa. Subscapular fossa. Then, can we all see this wing-like structure that looks like a wing? This is referred to as the acromion of the scapula. And you can see the acromion giving off the acromial process of the scapula. So this is the acromial process of the scapula. Why the acromial process of the scapula continues behind as the spine of the scapula? It continues behind as the spine of the scapula. So this is the acromial process of the scapula. The acromion continues as the spine of the scapula. You can see this sharp edge is the spine of the scapula. Then we also have this structure that is like a hook. This is referred to as the coracoid process of the scapula. This is referred to as the coracoid process of the scapula. Then if you look at behind, just directly behind the coracoid process, there is a hole here. I place this marker in this hole. This hole is referred to as the suprascapular notch. It's referred to as the suprascapular notch. Then if we've seen these features, we come to this particular fissure here. You can see this depression here. This depression here is referred to as the glenoid cavity. This is the glenoid cavity. As a matter of fact, this is one of the articular surface of the shoulder joint. It is at this place that the head of the humerus articulates. So they join together to form the shoulder joint. So this is the glenoid cavity. Then around the glenoid cavity, we have the neck of the scapula. Around the glenoid cavity, we have the neck of the scapula. Then, above the glenoid cavity, there is a protrusion, and also below it, there is a protrusion. The protrusion above the glenoid cavity is referred to as the supraglenoid tubercle. While the protrusion down here is referred to as the infraglenoid tubercle. So, I believe we've been able to see all the important features of the scapula as a bone. So, ranging from the medial border, the lateral border, the superior angle, the inferior angle, the acromial process, the coracoid process, the spine of the scapula, the suprascapular notch, the suprascapular fossa, the infrascapular fossa, the subscapular fossa, the glenoid cavity, the neck of the scapula, the supraglenoid tubercle, and the infraglenoid tubercle. So we've come to the end of this video, and before I end the video, I would like you to watch out to our next video in the humerus. We'll be discussing the humerus in our next video, and I'd also like you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Learn with Chisholm Greats. Also, like, comment your questions, and also share this video. Thank you very much.